We are joined by Dr. John Grant and Dr. Mariah Baker, who are both planetary geologists and have worked on multiple Mars missions.
Thank you both for joining us today. John, we're learning about the Mars 2020 mission. Can you tell us about the search for life on Mars?
One of the important parts of looking for life on Mars is knowing where to go and what to look for. And the Mars program that's been put together is really geared towards doing just that. The missions that have led up to Perseverance have identified a landing site where we think we know where to go, and we've got the tools on board to look for the things we need to look for. And specifically, we're looking for biosignatures, the kinds of signatures that relate to evidence of past life.
John, there's also a pretty cool part of this mission, but it's going to take a little bit of time to pay off. Can you tell us about the sample return?
Sample return is really the gift that keeps giving. When we take a rover or a spacecraft to Mars, we can only bring a certain number of instruments with us, never as many as we'd like to have. And by bringing samples back to the Earth, that gives us a repository, sort of a legacy, that not only allows us to take those samples and parse them out through all kinds of different instruments, but it also allows us to keep some for 10, 50, 100 years down the road when new instruments are developed that allow us to extract new information from those samples.
Mariah, can you tell us how this mission will help us prepare to send humans to Mars?
Yeah, absolutely. Although the primary mission goal is to search for these ancient signs of life, one of the secondary goals is to prepare for future human exploration. So a large part of this, and something that I study myself, is understanding the environment. So things like wind, understanding dust activity, which we've seen has been a hazard before. We're also going to look into using this atmosphere to our benefit and using it as a resource. So the MOXIE instrument is going to try to intake carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and turn it into oxygen that can be used by astronauts. So the mission is really going to help us take a step forward towards making human exploration a reality.
Mariah, we've gone from Sojourner, which landed back in the 90s, through Spirit and Opportunity, Curiosity, and now Perseverance. Are these all totally separate missions, or are they connected?
Yeah, so every mission that we send to Mars has its own primary science goals, and the spacecraft design and mission architecture are based around those goals. But that being said, we have a long legacy of past missions, and so we often use the knowledge that we've gained from these past missions and the technology that we've tested before as a basis for guiding and designing these future missions. So for Mars 2020, for example, the basic design of the rover is based on the Curiosity rover design, but we've updated and upgraded the payload with new and upgraded instruments to specifically address the science goals of the mission.
John, a lot of us have been doing teleworking and distance learning, but driving rovers on Mars takes distance learning to a whole new level. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Some of us have actually been doing remote operations for a while, but now the entire operations team is doing that. And really what that means is all of your tools that you depend on to get the job done really have to function the way you hope they do. And I will say that every day when we have to do operations, I tend to start the day with a little bit of sweaty palms, hoping that all of those tools will work, because Mars doesn't care. We really have to be ready for what the rover is going to do and when it's going to do it.